So, are we going to make a stand now and draw a line in the sand and say here and no further? In fact, we're going to roll this back? Or are we going to wait until it's got really, really extreme, by which time there'll be so much infrastructure in place that drawing a line in the sand will be a serious challenge? And it's no good. I said to some policemen in Parliament Square a few months ago, ask yourself, when your child says to you, Mummy and Daddy, what were you doing when the police state was introduced? Oh, well, I was watching the telly, honey. Or in the policeman's case, I was helping to introduce it, dear. That's the situation we're facing. And you know, if people don't like it, well, they just have to do the other thing, because this is how it is. And we either face it now, or we face it a little bit further along the road, when if we think it's not very good now, it'll be a bloody nightmare by then. It's time to lift the arse off the sofa and bring an end to this nonsense. Because otherwise, we're just building our own prison cell or sitting around where someone does it. Is that sensible? I think not.
We have been labeled rebels, traitors, enemies of the state. All terms King George would have used to vilify our founders. I, for one, will always rebel against oppression, a traitor only to tyranny, and I would be remiss to not make myself the enemy of a state that so blatantly tramples our freedoms. American values have been nearly vanquished by consumerism, militarism, and authoritarianism. Yellow ribbons and lapel pins will not save this country. When injustice becomes law, resistance becomes duty. The utmost manifestation of love and devotion to America is today, as it always has been, resistance of tyranny. Resist we must. And resist we will. We will not be silent. We will not obey. We will not let our government destroy our humanity. We will not wait another moment in fear to stand up for what we know to be right. It is time we start meeting oppression with resistance. They cannot stop us. Humanity marches on. You can fight it or fight for it. When we say revolution, we say it with love. This young movement is getting past the external wounds to the greater evils plaguing this nation. We know that the greatest threat to American security is the current corruption of our government. No politician has ever ended a war. Civil rights were won in this country not by any legislator, but by a movement. I have great hope for America, but it comes not from any election. No. My hope comes from you. Our tragic love affair with the state has led us to put far too much trust in a government that we thought could improve our lives, but has instead come to rule our lives for us. We have become, as a people, like a frightened, battered, beat-down victim of an abusive relationship. A servile, unquestioning, obedient people will always produce tyrants. We must, as a nation, once again embrace defiance, rebellion, and resistance. Every day, more and more Americans are avoiding unenforceable taxes, leaving government jobs out of disgust, and sending their kids to college instead of combat. But our efforts as a movement must become unified and deliberate to fully withdraw our support and compliance. Be it with your lives, labor, or tax dollars, stop investing in your own oppression. Guard your communities from the police state. Don't waste a single vote or a single dollar on the two-party system. Do not be content merely to grumble and to march while they are using fear, force, and violence as weapons of oppression. We must embrace the opportunity to resist civilly while we still can. It has been said that when in the course of human events, an oppression so revolts its subjects that it becomes necessary to alter or abolish the means of that tyranny? Is it that time when our Bill of Rights is defiled every day? When our adventures abroad threaten our security at home? When the Federal Reserve keeps our free nation enslaved by debt? When the people of the world tremble under the thumb of corporate imperialism? And now, our nation is drifting dangerously from freedom to fascism. So I have to ask, is it time?
TV, The Drudge Report, Infowars.com, the whole world's watching. And what we learned from Texas will be used in other states to beat you globalist agents and mercenaries.
That's right.
And when we take America back, you Nazis are going to prison. Believe it, the lobbyists that serve tyranny, the politicians that serve tyranny, are going to prison. This is only the beginning. The answer to 1984 is 1776.
In the end, we will remember not the words of our enemies, but the silence of our friends. Silence is consent. Can you hear us now? Silence is consent, because while we're silent on these impositions, the impositions just keep going on and on and on. By our silence, we are acquiescing, even agreeing to them being imposed. The end of silence, the end of acquiescence. If we want to be free, then don't run and hide. Comply. No, no, no. Not if it's enslaving me and my children and imposing on my freedom. Comply, leave your home now it's foreclosed. No, no, no. Let's follow this through, shall we? Millions of people in the world are losing their homes, being foreclosed, and ending up homeless. Let's follow this through. Why have you lost your home, my friend? Because I can't pay me mortgage. Why can't you pay your mortgage? Because I lost my job. Why did you lose your job? Because the great banking collapsed. They can't get this. I can't get my company went bust. And who's taking your home away and saying you've got to leave? The banks that caused the freaking problem. And we are leaving? What are we doing? What are we doing? No, we won't leave when the banks have caused the problem and now they're telling us to leave to take the assets. No, we won't. And people who are not being foreclosed need to support those that are. We're all in this together. You must do what we say. We have changed the law. Not if you are imposing on my freedom and my rights to be a free citizen with a free voice. No, no, no. What are they gonna do? They come out of Downing Street, whether it's Clegg and his mate bloody Cameron or it's bloody Obama, whoever it is in America, and they say, we've had a discussion and this is what we're gonna do. What if vast numbers of people say, well, we ain't doing it? They've got no power whatsoever. Their power comes in our acquiescence. Oh, but you can't defy the law. Okay, let's follow this through, shall we? By the way, while I'm talking, put your arms out and I'll put the handcuffs on, because that's what you're telling me. What you're telling me is this. We have no say in laws that are passed. And then we have to obey those laws. Well, okay, forget freedom then. Okay, what if they passed a law that says we take your children away? Would you obey it? No. So there is a line then. There is a line. It's just, where is that line? And if a law does not respect human freedom, it does not respect human justice, it doesn't respect fair play, we should not be acquiescing to those laws. We should be refusing to acquiesce. What we need is not compliance, we need a non-comply dance. Where we beat to a different drum and we dance to a different drum. Where we refuse to acquiesce to this control system that seeks to enslave us even more than it already has. Non-comply dance. Do this, comply! No. No. But we need to do it en masse. Oh, we do it with a smile on our face. We're consciousness, all that has been ever will be. Why shouldn't we have a smile on our face? And smile and feel for these people who are enclosed in mind trying to enslave us. I am all that is, has been, ever will be. You cannot grant me my freedom. It is not your gift to grant me my freedom or take it away, because I am, we all are, freedom. Enough. Enough of this suppression. Enough of this slavery. Enough of this enslavement of the few by the many. Human race, get off your knees. What are we doing down there? As the poet Shelley said, rise like lions after slumber in unvanquishable number. Shake your chains to earth like dew, which in sleep had fallen on you. Ye are many, they are few. Enough! It's time to fly. It's time to fly. Thank you very much.
There's a time when the operation of the machine becomes so odious, makes you so sick at heart, that you can't take part, you can't even passively take part, and you've got to put your bodies upon the gears and upon the wheels, upon the levers, upon all the apparatus, and you've got to make it stop, and you've got to indicate to the people who run it, to the people who own it, that unless you're free, the machine will be prevented from working at all.
Somewhere a perversion has taken place. Our natural, unalienable rights are now considered to be a dispensation of government. And freedom has never been so fragile, so close to slipping from our grasp as it is at this moment. The martyrs of history were not fools. And our honored dead, who gave their lives to stop the advance of the Nazis, didn't die in vain. Where then is the road to peace? Well, it's a simple answer after all. You and I have the courage to say to our enemies, there is a price we will not pay, there is a point beyond which they must not advance.